Hello CSPro users and welcome to CSPro video tutorial 5, Tabulate Data. In this exercise, we will perform simple cross-tabulations using the data entered in tutorial 4. I entered 100 households. I recommend you have at least 10 households in your data set for this exercise and the following exercises. If you still have your data entry application open from the previous exercise, as I do here, close it now. Click on File, Exit to exit data entry mode. We are now in the CSPro Data Entry Application Developer. Select File, Close from the main menu. CSPro may prompt you to save changes. If so, select Yes to save the changes. Select File, New from the main menu, or click on the new icon on the toolbar. Select Tabulation Application. I will keep this application in the My CSPro Tutorial folder, the folder we have been using. And I will give the application the name My Tabulation and click on Create. CSPro asks for the data dictionary for this tabulation application. Click on the ellipsis and select the dictionary. This is the dictionary we have been using for our data entry application. Click OK, and CSPro has now created for us an empty tabulation application. On the left side is the dictionary panel containing the dictionary tree. On the right is an empty table. This is where we will create the table. We will create a tabulation of age by sex. Age will appear as the rows and sex as the columns. If the dictionary panel does not show, click on the dictionary tab to see the dictionary tree. Click on the plus sign for the person record. This will open the tree so you see all the items in the person record. Drag and drop age from the dictionary tree to the table by clicking on age, holding the mouse button down while you move the mouse to the left side of the table. Then release the mouse button to drop age. The drop point should be in the white space next to one of the gray boxes along the side. Drag and drop sex from the dictionary tree by clicking on sex, holding down the mouse button, dragging sex to the top of the table, and releasing the mouse button. The drop point should be in the white space below one of the gray boxes along the top. Here are some tips. The item you drag from the dictionary tree will become either a row item or a column item, depending on where you drop it. Imagine a diagonal line from the top left to the bottom right of the table. An item dropped on the left under that line becomes a row. An item dropped on the right above that line becomes a column. You can remove an item from a table by clicking on any of its associated labels and dragging it back to the dictionary tree. Now there is no age in the table. I will drag age back to the table. When you have completed this step, the screen should look something like what you see here. We are now ready to run the tabulation. We will use the data file created in the previous exercise. Run the tabulation by clicking on the traffic light on the toolbar or by pressing Ctrl R. If CSPro prompts you to save the changes, click on Yes. CSPro will ask you for the name of the input data file. That is the file to tabulate. Navigate to the file created in exercise 4. make sure the dialog box is set to the folder you created for this exercise. In this example, I tabulate the file tutorial.dat. Select the file to tabulate by clicking on the file, click Open, click OK. CSPro runs the tabulation application, and tabulated numbers appear in the table. Congratulations! You have now created a table using CSPro.